Yes, last topic we are discussing list data type. Today we'll do the continuation of the list data type, and today we'll complete the list data type possible. Class notes part two we are discussing list data type. List data type. Yesterday we discussed list is ordered collection, right? List is ordered collection. So list ordered collection, list duplicates objects are allowed. List is immutable modifications are allowed, right? List is mutable modifications allowed. List is index based, support both positive and negative indexing, right? Yeah. Yesterday we done this all example data slicing and data unpacking. Okay. In the memory address, like memory is not keyword, double equal not equal to, okay, in and not in keyword, and working with the sublist, right? Working with the sublist, concatenation replication, min and max is complete, right? Exactly, guys. And coming to the today class, so we'll use for loop, guys. First example, for loop to process the data. Basically, if list contains list of elements, guys, list contains the multiple elements here. Simply can write the for x in name, right? For x in names means what happened here? The names means like multiple names. The loop is repeated for every name. Then the loop is repeated, right? The all the values will be printed, right? Exactly. Observe carefully, guys. But important here. Yeah, to run this code, simply can write the Python. The file is called what? Faster.py. Simply Python, yeah, Python. The file is called what? Faster.py, right? Exactly. The series code, guys. We got output Ratananu. Ratananu, Sravi, and what? Naresh, right? Exactly. Yes, list contains multiple names. I'm repeating all the names using for loop, right? Exactly. And even if you see, if you take the names of, you can take the slicing also, guys. Names of 2 to 4. Names of 2 to 4 means what happened? The corresponding elements will be printed. So, guys, 2 to 4 means what? I think Sravi and Naresh, right? 2 to 4 means it will take the 2 and 3. 2 and 3 means what? It will take the Sravi and Naresh, right? Exactly. And see one more point here. Good. So even if you get the one element, guys, fruits of 2. Fruits of 2 means what happened in this place? Which value is replaced? Tell me. Guys, fruits of 2 means this line, which value is replaced?
Orange
is replaced, right? See here, this line only orange is replaced. If orange is replaced, means then what happened, guys? Is the string is replaced, right? String is taken using the for loop means then what happened? Guys, string is repeated using for loop means then what happened? String is repeated using for loop means every character will be repeated, right? Yes or no? Every character will be repeated or not?
Yes.
Yeah, every character is repeated, right? Yeah, every character will be repeated. Every character is repeated means you'll get the output is what? Var ang, right? And we can run this code Python pub.py. So here the string is placed, guys. That's what you got the output is what? Var ang. Because here, how many values are replaced? Only one value is replaced. That is a string value replaced. The string is taken means what happened? The loop is repeated for every character, right? Exactly, guys. But see here, now I take the 2 to 3. Yes, 2 to 3 means it will take how many values? It will take one. 2 to 3 means 2 is included, 3 is excluded, right?
Yes.
Yeah, 2 to 3 means 2 is included, 3 excluded. I think here also it will take the data only orange, right? Exactly. Here also it will take the data only orange means. Then what happened, guys? Only orange is printed, ORANG is printed.
It's printed ORANG.
Yeah, exactly. See, guys. But here it won't print var ang, just is printing orange only one line. What the reason might be, tell me? Fruits of 2 means one element is there, that one element is taken as every character format in the for loop. Fruits of 2 to 3 is also one element only. But tell me, guys, here this one element is taken as a single element format, a list format. Fruits of 2 to 3 means
taking in the list for
exactly, because it's a slicing, right? 2 to 3. See, guys, fruits of 2 is a one element, but 2 to 3 means even though 2 to 3 one element only, but 2 to 3 means it's a slicing, right? Slicing, it will take the list. Slicing, it will take what type of data? Guys, slicing, it will take what type of data? List data, right? Yeah, list data. List means what? list of one element it will take. That's what it is printing, that one element, right? That's it printing one element or not. Exactly. Here we'll get the one element in the form of string, in the form of the list, in the form of what? List, because it is what? Slicing, right? Yes or no? Here we will get the one element, guys, in the form of the list, because it is which concept here? Slicing concept, right? Exactly. Guys, for example, you try to tell me the answer for this line 10, 20, 30, 40. So 30, 40, 50, four values are there. For x in data of 2 to 3, this case, what's output now? Yes, for x in data of 2 to 3, now what is the output?
30.
Yeah, 2 to 3 means here also it is taking the data in which format? Definitely. Yeah, here also it will take the data in which format? Slicing is list format. It is written in the list, specific list, which list? Only 30, right? Only 30. That's what you'll get. The output is what? Only 30, right? Exactly. But see, guys, the same code, if I place the data of 2 means, this case, what's output now? Guess data of 2 means, this case, what's output now?
That is also 30 because it's in the integer format.
Yeah. Tell me, guys, this case, what's output? Guys, this case, what is the output I'm asking? Definitely, this case generates some error messages, guys. What the reason? Tell me. See, guys, here the fruits of 2 means, fruits of 2 is taking only one element. Which element, guys? Orange. It is taking orange means then what happened? Orange is a string data, then is repeated for every character. But here data of 2 means it will take how many values? Only one value, right? One value is a 30. 30 means is that 30 is can be repeatable or not? Guys, is that 30 is writable or not?
No, integer value cannot be.
Yeah, that's what here. That's what we have to check, guys. If it is a slicing means, slicing returns the list format. List contains only one element also, no problem, that element will be printed. But data of 2 means it is a slicing or index. Index means it is taking list format or only one element. Yes, it is taking list format or only one element.
Only one element,
right? Exactly. It is taking only one element, guys. If it is taking one element means then what happened is that integer element, right? Integer element means is repeatable or not? Guys, it is repeatable or not? It is repeatable or not?
No,
right? That's why it's saying error message. Int object is what? Not iterable, right? Guys, I hope you got the clarity between the for loop, right? How to process the data. Exactly. Guys, first for loop is printing all elements. Next for loop is printing like 2 to 4. Next for loop is 2. Even though if you give the 2, then what happened, guys? Even if you give the 2, 2 is taken as orange, that is a string data. The string is repeated for every character, right? Guys, string is repeated for every character. Here, even though you can write the 2 to 3 is only one element only. But 2 to 3 means it is taking the data in which format, guys? List format. 2 to 3 is taking the list format means it is printing that element, right? Guys, it is printing that element or not? Exactly. Data of 2 to 3. Data of 2 to 3 means then what happens here? It is printing like, guess data of 2 to 3, 10, 20, 30, 40, yes. 50. It's printing the corresponding values, right? Yeah, 2 to 3 or 2 to 4, something like. Data of 2 means what happened, guys? Here only one value is placed. Which value here? Only 30 is placed. So only 30 is placed. Then this is iterable or not iterable? Guys, this is iterable or not? Then definitely it's not iterable, right? Exactly, guys. Guys, is the for loop is clear, everyone? Yeah, you try to check every possibility, right? But because multiple possibilities we have. Okay, good, guys. Guys, next one you can see, I want to add some data into list, guys. I want to add some like 1 to 6 elements in the list. Okay, to add some data into the list, 1 to 6 elements, as room like 1 to 5. I want to add 1 to 5, guys. Every element is a multiplication of 99. Okay. As what I want to add the data in here, I want to take the 1 to 5. I want to add 1 to 5. Every element is the multiplication of 99. Because I want to add how many elements? 1 to. Because I want to add the data like 1 to 5. Every element is multiplication of 99. It's nothing but a 99th table, right? Exactly. Just to add the data, directly can take a list format. Take the for loop, guys. For x in range of, I have to take the 1 to 5, right? 1 to 5 means I can take the 1 to 6, right? Because if you give the 1 to 5 means 5 is included, excluded. Because 1 to 5 means 5 is included, exclude, right? That's what you can take the 1 to. That's what you can take the 1 to. 1 to, 1 to, 1 to.
1 to 6.
So you guys, 1 to 6 you can take, right? If you take the 1 to 6, that will be fine. See, guys, if you take the for loop inside the list, square brackets is list format, right? This is a for loop, guys. For x in 1 to 6 means x contains like what are the elements here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? Left-hand side, guys. Left-hand side here, we have to do the x variable. Yes, left hand side we have to the x variable. Then this x variable goes to this x value. Okay, this x data variable. This x goes to data variable, guys. This x goes to data variable means what? This x is nothing but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? Then if you're trying to print the data here, if you're trying to print the data now, it's printing like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? Guys, are you clear now? Good. So, guys, can I write one more and get the more clarity? For x in a range of 1 to 6, then it will take the x values like 1 to 5. Then here, this x contains what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, something like that, right? X star, you can put the 99 here. Yes, x star 99, I can put here. X star 99 means then what happened, guys, here? X is like 1 into 99, 2 into 99, 3 into 99, 4 into 99, 5 into 99. Whatever the operation you applied here, that operation value goes to, yeah. The operation value goes to data variable, right? Exactly, guys. Now we can see the code once. 99, 198, 297, 396, 495. Guys, you got the clarity right now. Yeah. What is this for loop? You got the clarity right? Exactly. Guys, this case, what is the output? Tell me now. Yeah, this line was output now. L3 value. Guys, L3 values, what is output? For x in a range of 1 to 6, if x percentile to w equals 0, this condition has to be satisfied x value. X percentile to
4 w. 4 and 8.
Sorry?
4 and 8.
X double equal to percentile to w equals 0 means what? We will take the even values, right? Even values means what? X can take only 2 and 4 it will take. But what are the values you are taking? 2 star 2, right? 2 star 2, 4 star 2. 2 star 2 means what? 4. 4 star 2 means what? 8, right? So 4 and 8, guys. Guys, what is the output now? 4 and 8, right? Exactly. See the output, guys? Yeah? 4 and 8. Like that, we can apply the condition even and we can take the corresponding data into the list format, right? Guys, we can take the corresponding data in what? List format, guys. This is a for loop to add the data. Guys, see this code once. This line was output, expected output. For x in a range of 1 to 6, here this data goes to L4. This data goes to L4 means what? I think this is sublist, right? Sublist format, right? Exactly. Sublist format means what type of data here? Assume like it will take the 1 and 1. First value is taking the 1 and 1. Second one is what? 2 and 4, right? Because like 2 comma 2 star 2, 2 comma 4, 3 comma 9, 4 comma 16, 5 comma 25. Sorry, no, guys. X comma x star x. See this code here. First case 1 comma 1. Next case 2 4. Next case 3 9. Next case 4 16. 5 25, right? Guys, are you clear now? That is information, guys. Good. So next one, you can see this line once, L5. Yes, last line, this line, what's output? Tell me now. Yes, this line, what's output now? For x in a range of 1 to 10, okay, it will take the values from 1 to 10. X percentile to w equal 0, and x should be less than 7. X should be
2, 4, 6.
Yes, what's the output now? X percentile to 0 and x less than 7, right? Guys, are you able to understand these loops, right? Or the syntaxes, right? Guys, are you able to understand the syntaxes or not? For x in a range, this is the data. Okay, what is the condition for this? If x w equal to x percentile to w equal 0, and one more condition is what? X less than 7. Then you'll get the output is what? 2, 4, and 6, right? Exactly. Yes, last one you can see the output once, 2, 4, 6. Yes, you got the previous example, for loop to print the data. This example, for loop to add the data, right? guys, for loop to add the data. Guys, two examples are clear? Guys, two examples are clear or not? Good. Example three, we can apply relational operators on the list data, guys. Example three. If you apply the relational operator on the list data, now you can see, guys, L1 greater than L2, L1 less than L2. Okay. Here you will check the first element, guys. Element by element checking here. First element is matched. Second element is matched. Then it apply for data on the third element, right? 5 and 8. See, guys, here 5 greater than 8. 5 greater than 8 means true or false? Guys, 5 greater than 8 means true or false? False, right? This one 5 less than 8? Yes, 5 less than 8 is true, right? Exactly. So first line will get the false, guys. Next line will get the true, right? I say the output here. First line will get the false. Next line will get the true, right? Exactly. False and true, guys. That is information basically. Is it clear now? Yeah, so it will check the first element, second element is matched, first element is matched, then you will check the third element, 5 and 8, right? 5 greater than 8 and 5 less than 8, right? Exactly, guys. And definitely this line, what is output, guys, once? Yeah, this line, what is output now? Yeah, this line, what is output, guys, tell me? So names 1, names 2 is there. Names 1 greater than names 2, names 1 less than names 2. What is output now? I think first one is matched, Ratan is matched. Second one we have to check, Ravi Kiran and Ramesh. Even Ravi Kiran and Ramesh also, I think first character is matched, second character is matched. Then we have to check the characters from V and M, right? Yes or no, V and M. Then tell me, guys, is that V greater than M or not? Yes, V greater than M or not. I think definitely V greater than M only, right? True, right? Exactly. So V is definitely greater than M, guys. I written the true. Next one is what? V less than M. It returns the last line is what? You get the false, right? Exactly. Yes, yes or no? True and false, right? Exactly. Guys, first case like integer data. So we check it. Second case is string data. Even first string is matched to second string. Second string also it will check the data in alphabetical order. First character is matched to second character is matched to third character, right? Third character is like V and M, right? Exactly, guys. That information basically. Good. And if you see this lines once, this case, what's the output, guys? I think first one is matched, first element is matched or not matched? Guys, first element is matched or not matched? First element is matched, right? First element is matched means it will go for the second element, right? The second element is matched or not matched?
Matched, sir.
Wrong. Yes, first one is matched, right? First one is matched means it will check for the second element, right? Yes, it will check for the second element. I think second element is matched or not matched. Yeah, first element is matched. I think second element is matched, right? Yeah, second element is also matched, right? Second element is matched means what? One and true, right? One and true means. One is match, one and true means both are same, right? Exactly. It will check for the false and 10, guys. False and 10 means, yeah, false and 10 means what's the output now? Guys, false and 10 means what is the output? Yeah, false and 10 means like, false and 10 means data 1 greater than data 2, right? Data 1 greater than data 2 means what? Data 1 is a false. I think 0 greater than 10. 0 greater than 10 means what? It's a false, right? Yeah, it's a false. And this is like true, right? This is second is a true, guys. Last two lines, one is a false, second one is a true, right? This is like false and a true, guys. Is that clear now? Just applying the relational operators on the string data, guys. Applying what? Relational operators on the string data. And if you take the next one here, See guys, here if you take the first element, here first element is Ten and Ratan. Guys, Ten and Ratan means one type of data, different types of data. Guys, Ten and Ratan means one type of data, different types of data. It's like different types of data, right? Different types of data. Can we check? Can we do the comparison?
No,
right? Greater than less than symbols not apply, right? Yeah, different types of data, we cannot apply the greater than less than symbols, guys. That's what we'll get. The output is what here? Error, right? Which error, guys? Type error. When you're trying to, okay, combine the two different types of data or trying to apply the greater than symbols between the two different types of data, two different types of data, we are trying to do any operation, you'll get which error, guys? There's two different types of data. If you're doing any operation, you'll get which error here? Type error, right? Exactly. Guys, are you clear? The first example is what? For loop to print the data. Second example is for loop to add the data. And the third example is like relational operators, right? Guys, third example is like what? Relational operators or not. Exactly. And if you go for the fourth example, guys, sort versus sorted. Okay. Sort versus sorted, guys. If you take the sort versus sorted, I want to sort the data. Tell me, guys, I have the names. Some names are there. Ratan, Anu, Sravya, Naresh. names.sort print of names. names.sort print of names means they're not happening, guys. After sorting the data, the names will be printed, right? Exactly. It's fine. See, guys, data is sorted or not sorted? Guys, data is sorted or not sorted? Sorted, right? Anu, Naresh, Ratan, Shravya. Yes or no? Good. Sir, I want descending order. If you want descending order, guys, names.sort we can use. Then here we have to put the reverse equal to true. If you make the reverse equal to true, then what happened, guys, here? Then reverse equal to true means it is printing like descending order. See, guys, one is a ascending order, one is a descending order, right? Yes or no? This is like descending order, right? Sravya, Ratan, Naresh, and Anu, right? Exactly. Ascending order, what a descending order, right? Exactly, guys. And the next one is like, this is like sort, guys. Sort means what happened here? The data which is there in the memory is sorted, right? Guys, the data present in the memory will be sorted. Okay? The data present in the memory will be sorted. And if you take some, okay, if you take some names like fruit names here, fruits, apple, mango, banana, orange, something like this. Tell me, guys, here I want to sort the data, See, my question is here. I don't want to sort the data in the memory. In the memory, I don't want to sort the data. The values will be fixed here. I don't want to change this order, guys. But I need the output in sorting order. Guys, in the memory data, I don't want to change. Guys, in the memory data, I don't want to change. But I need output in which format, guys? Guys, I need output in which format? Sorting format. I need output in sorting format. Just I need the report in the sorting format. I don't want to sort my values, guys. Just if we need the output in sorting format, but if you don't want to sort your data, then you can go for one function like sorted function, guys. But the function name here is sorted of, you can write the fruits basically. Sorted of fruits means then what happened here? Output is printed in the sorting order, okay? But again, you're trying to print the fruits, so this data is not changed again. This data is fixed, guys. Guys, this data will be fixed, right? Exactly. Now run this code here. See, sorted of fruits means what? The data is printing in sorting order or not? Guys, data is printing in sorting order or not? But after that, I'm printing the fruits means it's printing like memory data. Is any changes there? Guys, memory data, any change is there? There is no change, right? Exactly. Guys, then tell me what the difference between the sort versus sorted. The difference between the sort versus sorted is sort means what happened, guys? Sort means our data present in the memory. Okay, the data present in the memory, the data will be sorted. Guys, sort means what? The sort means the data present in the memory will be sorted, right? The data present in the memory will be sorted. And sorted means what happened, guys? The data present in the memory is not sorted, guys. But the output is printed in which order, guys? Sorted format, right? Guys, but the output is printed in which order? The output is printed in which order means sorting order, right? Exactly. Guys, you got the clarity, right? Different between sort versus sorted. Sort means the data present in the memory will be sorted. Next level, if you read the data, sorting data you will get. Sorted means what? Data present in the memory which is not sorted. Only just output is printed in sorting format, guys. Okay, sorting format, right? Exactly. Yes, if you need the output in reverse order, then you can write the fruits, order of fruits. Then you can take the reverse equal to what? Reverse equal to true, right? Reverse equal to true means then what happened is, again, data is printed in descending order, right? See these data ones. Orange, mango, banana, apple. Does data is printed in reverse order or not? Data is printed in reverse order, right? Guys, I hope you got the clarity between the, okay, reverse and, yes, sort versus sorted, right? Sort means the data present in the memory sorted, guys. Reverse order means reverse data. Sorted means what? The data present in memory which is not sorted. Just output is printed in which order, guys? Just output is printed in the sorting order. Guys, that point is clear. Just output is printed in which order, guys? Output is printed in the sorting order, right? Yeah, that is information, guys. And see, can we sort this data? Guys, can we sort this data? Check the output once. Data equal to 10 comma 10.5 comma true is there. Can we sort this data? Guys, can we sort this data or not? Yeah, if we sort this data, what's the expected output now?
True 10.
Yeah, we'll get output is like true 10 to 10.5. Exactly, guys. We can sort this data, it's not a problem, right? So true 10 to 10.5. Exactly. Guys, but see, if I'm trying to sort the 10 rather than 10.5, because to perform the sorting operation, it has to apply the greater than less than symbols, right? Guys, to perform the sorting operation, it is apply the greater than less than symbols or not? It has to be apply the greater than less than symbol, right? Then here 10 rather than 10.5 means then what happened now? 10 rather than 10.5 means what happened now? So 10 rather than, is that comparison is possible? While doing the sorting, it has to apply greater than less than symbols, right? Which one has to come first, which one has to come next, right? Guess yes or no? It has to apply the greater than less than symbols or not? In that case, yeah, in that case, can we apply the greater than less than symbols here? Guys, can we apply the greater than less than symbols here? No, right? Because no. We have two different types of data. If two different types of data means we cannot apply, right? Yeah, two different types of data means we cannot apply. Then you will get the message like, you get the message like what? Type error, right? Exactly, guys. So you're saying like type error, greater than is not supported between the instance of what? String and integer, right? Okay, string and what? Integer. Yeah, that is information, guys, regarding sort versus what? Sorted, guys. Guys, total how many examples here in total? Here? Four examples. First example, for loop to print the data. Second example, for loop to add the data. Third example, relational operators, greater than less than symbols you applied. Fourth example, sort versus sorted. So sort means the memory data will be sorted. Sorted means the data is not sorted, but the output is printed in which order, guys? The report is generated in the sorting order, right? Yeah, the report is generated in the sorting order, guys. Exactly. Yeah, good, guys. And see, the next points here, different ways you can add the data in the list, guys. One is append operation. See this code in explanation required append operation. Data equal to 1, 10, 20, 30, 40. Append of 100, append of 50. Assume like append of 50 I'm adding. 50 then added at last position, right? Guys, 10, 20, 30, 40 is there. I'm using append function. Append function by default append the data at last or not? Append function by default append the data at the last, guys. Then see the output ones. We got the output is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, right? Exactly. Sir, I don't want insert the last. I want insert the specific index, specific location. If you want insert it at a specific location, guys, you can go for the specific operation like this. Insert of one. In first position, guys, names contains Ratan, Anu, Sravi initially. Insert of one. In the first location, can please insert the Naresh. Okay. In the first location, if I want insert the Naresh, then what happened, guys? Here, the first location already Anu is there, right? Anu go to the next location, guys. Anu goes to next location, right? Exactly. Then we get output is what? Ratan, Naresh, Anu, Sravi, right? Yes, yes or no? Ratan, Naresh, Anu, and what? Sravi, right? Exactly. Next one is what, guys? Names dot insert of 10 in the 10th position. 10th position insert the Ravi. But guys, tell me, 10th position, do you have any element here? Guys, 10th position, do you have any elements? There is no element, right? 10th position, there is no element, guys. By default, it is added at last position. Guys, 10th position, there is no element. By default, it adds the data at last position, right? Yeah, by default, it adds the data at last position. In this case, what the output expected here? Let me guess. Ratan, Naresh, Anu, Stravya, Ravi. Is it clear now? First case, append operation, guys. Just appending the data at last by default. Second is insert operation. We can insert the data at specific location, guys. Insert the data at specific location. And if you want to replace the data, guys. If you want to replace the data, then we can check like, if you want to replace the data, guys. So data contains like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Data contains like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Guess data contains what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If data contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, in the data of third position, data of third position, I'm inserting what type of data, guys? Guys, data of third position, I'm inserting what type of value? 10, right?
Interesting.
Now we can see the output here. The expected output will be the, see, third position means what? 0, 1, 2, 3, right? Index, this is called index third, guys, not element third, right? Data of 3 means index 3rd. Index 3 means this is the index 3, right? Fourth element. So index starts from 0, 1, 2, 3. The fourth element, 10 is added or not? This is called replacing the data, guys. Good. First case like append the data. Second case like insert the specific location. The third case like replacing the data, right? Third position like replacing the data. And even you can replace the data the specific values also, like 10, 20. Guys, in this case, what happened? Data of 2, I'm placing like 10, 20. In this case, what's the output now?
Guys, these are examples you have to analyze. You have to analyze and you have to tell me the answer.
It's taking like elements. In the second location, what happened, guys? Third, second location, 10, 20 is inserted, right? Yeah, it is taking like sublist format, right? That is important point. Sublist format, it will take the data. Now see the output, guys. The second position, 1020 is added in sublist format, right? Okay, second position, 1020 is added in which format? Sublist format or not? 1020 is added in the sublist format, right? Exactly. Guys, are you clear now? Yeah, 1020 is added in which format, guys? Sublist format, right? Exactly. There's information, guys. Guys, any questions now? Yeah, and if we take the next one, guys, here I'm doing the slicing. There's multiple possibilities, guys. That's it. Don't confuse multiple possibilities, because application level, some interviews level, written test level, these all possibilities are important. See, guys, here I taken 1, 2, 3 in place of 1, 2, 3. See, data of 2 means second position you're replacing like 10, 20, third position you're replacing like 10. Here 1, 2, 3 means what? In place of 1, 2, 3, it replaced like what? 10, 20, 30, right? Exactly. 1, 2, 3 means what the data, guys? Guys, 1, 2, 3 means what the data here? I think it will take the 2 and 3, right? Guys, it will take the data like 2 and 3. So now see the output once. 2 and 3. See the output once. See, guys. Here it is taking the sublist format, elements format. It is taking elements format, right? 10, 20, 30 is added in the 3 elements format, right? Exactly. Because left hand side slicing is there, right? That's what right hand side is taking the elements format, right? Okay, so now this is taking the slicing format, right? Exactly. Yes, you got the clarity, right? Oh my god, multiple possibilities are there. Just you try this possibility once. Yeah, this case, what the expert output tell me now? 2, 2, 3. 2, 2, 3 means I think in place of in place of 2, 2, 3 means what? I think 3, 4, right? 3, 4. In place of 3, 4, in place of 3, 4, which one? Oh, 2, 2, 3 means what? 3 is excluded, right? Only it will take the 2, guys. It will take the 2, yeah, it will take only 2, right? Because 2, 2, 3 means ending value is excluded, right? Ending value is excluded, right? Exactly. Is all places are clear? Because all places are clear, right? Yeah, exactly. But see, guys, here I mentioned the data like 2, 2, 2. Yeah, check this data, guys. Data of this is the data like 2, 2, 2, guys. The 2:2. 2:2 means starting 2, ending 2, guys. Starting 2, ending 2 means 2 included, excluded. 2 included, excluded means there is no nothing value, right? Now see this value once. Last line you can see the output, guys. I think in the second position, guys, 0, 1, 2. In the second position, it excluded, guys. It means without replacing any data, just we is adding the data in this location, right? Right. This is also just like insert, guys. 2, 2, 2 means what? It won't take the 2 value because it ignores the 2 value. Just also this is like inserting. It is inserted the data to specific position, right? Guys, yes or no? Yeah, that is information, guys. 2 comma 2 means there is information. Okay, good, guys. Our next one you can see copy function, guys. Copy function just will copy the data. There's a replacement, guys. We done with the replacement here. Replace the data, can just to check the values, guys. All values. Data of 3 means third position is placed here. Data of 2 means what? The second position is replaced to 1, 2, 3 means what? In that place replaced. 2, 2, 3 means what? Only one value placed, right? 2 placed, which is like 3. Here replaced. 2, 2, 2 means what happened, guys? Any value is replaced here. Nothing is replaced in the second position, just this data will be inserted, right? Second position, the data will be. Yeah, second position, the data will be inserted, right? Exactly, guys. Next, guys, you can see, guys, copy and copy function, guys. I have the fruits. I want to copy this data. To copy this data, simply I can take the copy function, guys. Fruits.copy function. Fruits.copy function means what happened, guys? It will copy the data. After copying, your fruits and copied fruits, both memories are same memories or different memories, guys? Yes, I'm copying your data. I'm copying your data means then your memory, my memory, both memories are same memories or different memories?
Different memories.
Yeah, so tell me, guys, is a coin the same memory, different memories? Definitely it is a same memory or different memories means definitely it is a different memory, right? Exactly. That's what we got the values like. That's what we got the values like. Values like what? First means what, guys? Fruits is copy data. True or false?
False. It's false.
Yeah, it's false. Next one is a fruits double equal to copy data.
It's true.
Because double equal for the data comparison, right? I think data is same. So data is same. That's why you get the true, right? Yeah, this is like false, guys. And this is like true, right? Last two lines, one is a false, the second one is a true, right? Exactly, guys. This is a copying the data. Guys, first one is like append the data specific position, insert the data, then replacing the data in specific positions and copy the data. That is like copying operation, right? Exactly. Next one you can see extend operation, guys. What the purpose of extends means? Extend is used to add one list into another list, guys. So L1 contains what the values here? 10, 20, 30. L2 contains what the values? 40, 50, 60. L1 contains 10, 20, 30. L2 contains 40, 50, 60. L1 dot extend of L2. Okay, L1 dot extend of L2. L1 dot extend of L2 means then what happened, guys? It is adding L2 data into what? L1, right? That is adding what? L2 data into what? L1. To add one list into another list, guys. To add one list into another list, we are using which function here? To add one list into another list, we are using which function here? Extend function, right? Extend is used to add the one list into what? Another list, guys. Good. See, guys, concat method, like plus operator purpose is what? Adding L1 plus L2, the result is stored into third variable, right? Yes, concatenation means what? L1 plus L2 we are adding, L1 plus L2, and L1 plus L2 we are adding, the data is stored into what result variable, right? There's some third variable, right? Exactly. But what about this one, guys? Extend operation. L1 dot extend of L2 means? Guys, tell me L1 dot extend of L2. L1 dot extend of L2 means what the value? L1 dot extend of L2 means then what the value, guys? And definitely adding L2 data into what? One list into another list, right? Exactly, guys. Adding one list into what? Another list. Just you can see the output, guys. Printing L1 is what? 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, right? So L1 dot extend of L2 means adding one list into what? Another list, right? Exactly, guys. Guys, first one is append operation. So appending the data at last. Second is insert operation. Insert the data specific location. Next one is like replacing operation. And next one is like copy the data. Next one is adding one list into another list, right? Exactly. Guys, are it clear? This is one of the examples, guys. Adding the data. Guys, can you take the one more example or we will stop for today? I think done the more operations. Okay, one more example is there, guys. Just you can see this one more example so that I will complete these examples. Yeah, remove the data, guys. To remove the data, we have the remove function, simply. Guys, to remove the data, we have the remove function. Remove of banana means what happened, guys? The banana will be removed, right? Guys, remove of banana means what happened? Banana will be removed. Just see the output, guys, here. We got the mango and apple. Banana is removed, right? So using remove function, we can remove the data, guys. And second function using pop function. Pop function also used to remove the data, guys. Pop function used to remove the data. Pop function will remove the data based on the index, guys. Based on the index. Pop of 2 means what happened, guys, here? Pop of 2 means second element will be deleted. Pop of without index, guys. Pop of without index means what? By default, it removes the data at last. Okay. Pop off, generally we have to give the index, guys. If we didn't give the index, then what happened?
It removes the end of the variable.
Last, right. Guys, after these two statements, what are the output remaining values?
Ratan and Danu.
After removing these two lines, the output will be what? Ratan and Danu, right? Exactly. We got the output is Ratan and Danu, guys. That's it. That's the pop function, guys. Next one is the delete keyword. A delete keyword delete the data based on the slicing, guys. Delete keyword used to delete the data using slicing format. See, guys, after deleting these two lines, this line, what is the output now? Yes, after deleting the data, then what is this line output now? Guys, the question is clear. Error, why? No error, Venkatesh. We'll get the output new home. Guys, after deleting the 2-2 ending, 1-2 starting, then what's the output now? 2-2 ending. Starting to 1. Yeah, what is the output now? Guys, deleting the data 2-2 ending and 2-2 ending and 1-2. See, guys. Yeah, we'll get the output is what? 3, yeah. 3 deleted, Priyanka. 2 to ending means what? This is the 2, right, Priyanka? 2 from starting to it deleted everything, right? Then this is the data. In this one, starting to 1. Starting to 1 means what? This is like starting value. 1 is excluded, included here. 1 is excluded. What is excluded means what? This is excluded, right? Guys, this is a slicing, like we can say like indexing. Don't think like 2 means what from here this one is removed like that, right? 2 means 2 index. 2 index means what from here onwards it deleted data like this. Next one is what? Starting to 1. Starting to 1 means 1 is included, excluded. That's what it is. It's on the data only 2, right? Because it contains the data is what? 2, right? That's it. We got out with 2, guys. There's information. Exactly, guys. Next one you can see clear function. Clear means it removes everything, guys. Clear function removes all the values, right? Yeah, basically there are 4 ways you can delete the data, guys. One is a remove function, remove the base and the object. Remove function removes the data based on the object. Pop function removes the data based on the index based. Delete keyword to remove the data based on the slicing. And clear will remove the complete data, right? Clear the complete values, guys. Guys, are you clear now? It's like removing the data basically. Good. And last example, like length function, guys. Length of numbers. Length of numbers means what? The corresponding length will be printed. Count of 10. Count of 10 means 10 is occurred how many times? Guys, 10 is occurred how many times? Index of 30. Index of 10. Index of 10, comma 2 means what? From the second value onwards, when the index of 10 is occurred, right? Guys, 10 comma 2 means what? Starts from 2. Starts from 2 from second index onwards, where the 10 is occurred. I think this is the value, right? Exactly, guys. Reverse is to reverse the data, guys. Data equal 10, 20.3. Return true. I want reverse the data means you can reverse it. Here we'll discuss length function, count the number of occurrences, index function, get the index position of the corresponding character, and reverse function to reverse your data. Right? Exactly, guys. And I hope you know to check the functions are present in the list. To check the functions are present in the list. Any maybe string, list, tuple, any data, guys, to check the predefined functions, you can go for directive function, right? To check the functions present in the list, we are using directory function, right? is called directory of list, guys. Directory of list means what? It shows this all the functions, right? Exactly, guys. Good. Guys, you try to check these assignments once. Today, just at least to try to complete this assignment, guys. Take the list of EV values from 1 to 20. Yesterday, I given this assignment, right? I think. First two assignments I given yesterday, right? Exactly. Yeah. And the third assignment, you can see. Numbers, you can take like 10, 11, 3, 4, 5, this value, guys. In above list, to take the all odd values, print the data in descending order. Okay. Guys, in this data, take all odd values. Take all odd values, print the data in descending order. Guys, that point is clear. Print the data in which order, guys? Descending order, right? Print the data in descending order, right? Exactly. And this assignment is not required, guys. 4 and 5 is a simple things. It's not much great values. Yeah. So first one is okay, second one is okay, third one is okay. Fourth, fifth one, if you want, you can try once. Replace the fourth index with the 40. Add the 10 at last. Add the 20 at second location. Print the min and max value solution, right? Print the min and max value solution, guys, after adding this data. Next one is also remove the data. Next one is what? Sixth element is what? L1, L2, guys. Print the common values from both L1, L2, guys. This is very, very important. As stars are given, right? Multi important assignment, guys. What are the common values in the both list, guys? So here 10, 20 is a common value, right? So print the common values both in L1 and L2. What are the common values, guys? 10 and 20, right? Exactly. Okay, this is also very, very important. Seventh one. Seventh one is what is important, guys. So 10, 20, 1, 2, 3, 4. Addition of these all elements, guys. 10 plus 20, 30, 30 plus 1, 31, 31 plus 2, 33, 33 plus 6, 36, 36 plus 4, 40. I need the element of all addition, all the values, guys. Is it clear now? Good. And see, I need the output like this, guys. I need the output like x, double x, triple x, 4x's, 5x's. I need the output like this. I don't know how you write the code. You write the code. I need the output like this. Next one is what here? 2 jets, 4 jets, 8 jets, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 jets required. Good. And the ninth example, guys, you try to check this example and try to write the output of this example, guys. Ninth and tenth examples, you try to run the, you try to write output of every line, you try to see the output, guys. This is all about your list data, guys. Total almost all we done like 10 assignments here. 10 assignments here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 is also assignment, guys. Operations on the list data, assignment. Run the code, check the output. Guys, run the code on what? Check the output. What is the behavior we have to check, guys? Run the code and check the output, right? Exactly. Guys, are you clear now? So, 10th example also assignment. Run the code and check the output, guys. That's all about your list information, guys. We done the list data type. Guys, we completed list, guys. You try to check the list examples. We'll meet in tomorrow. We will think about tuple data type, second data type, guys. We'll discuss about the tuple data type, right? Exactly. So progress.com/python6pm. Yeah, python6pm. Then you can, yeah, python6pm. So the password is like Python, right? Python is the password. List data type, guys. So this is a day 2. Okay, fine. Everything is okay here. Just you can check the list data type, guys. We'll meet in tomorrow. We'll think about the tuple data type. Okay, bye, guys. Tomorrow we'll meet. Guys, do the assignments, please. Do the practicals.